toilet. Ladies and gentlemen, it's the Kate Robbins Show. And here she is, Kate Robbins.
Good evening and welcome to the show. Now, this is the very studio where the krypton factor is actually made. I know it is because I had to pass an intelligence test just to get my dressing room key. And honestly, you should see my dressing room. Honestly, I was told I'd get a suite that would take my breath away. They gave me a fisherman's friend. Now, the reason I'm telling you these fascinating jokes is because I'm trying to sort of make time, because it allows time for the lads to actually get here, because they are late. And any minute they're going to be here, I'm sure. That's Ted, Mike and Paul. They've just arrived. Have they just arrived? Yes, they've just arrived straight from Kempton Park Racecourse. I happen to know that they put all their money on a horse at 20 to 1 and it didn't come in till 3:30. Thank you. How nice of you to get here. The state of you. As you're actually here, perhaps you'd like to tell the people here what we've got in the show tonight. Ted, would you like to tell anybody? Thank you. How about you, Michael? Thank you, Paul. Well, thank you for being so informative. So, it's on with the show. Thank you.
Saturday night at the drive-in, you should be having some fun. With a slap and a kiss in the back of the car, holding hands with your number one. A smooch with your man, that's my normal plan. Only this time it wasn't so neat, because when he called around, guess what I found? Standing outside in the street. Standing outside in the street. At sight of his new bubble. Boyfriend has got a three-wheeler, cause you don't stand a chance of going too far. When you're backache and you've lost a healer, you bent into, you've lost your shoe, and you've dislocated your knee. It's impossible, the only thing you pull is your top free bird and prey. It ain't a bubble, the trouble in a bubble.
I'd like, if I may, to appeal on behalf of one of society's most hard-pressed minorities. Those few who suffer from an acute disadvantage in life. Those people who, through no fault of their own, happen to be princesses. One cannot imagine the pains that princesses have to live with. Better known to you, of course, as the Princess of Wales and Duchess of York. So what can you do to help? Well, I am sure you all remember Comic Relief. That was the day Lloyd Webber offered my brother Edward a job. In fact, I asked Lloyd Webber if he still has to bow and scrape every time they meet. Lloyd Webber said, he does if he wants to work for me. as with comic relief, an entire television channel will be given over to the Princess-a-thon. And the great news is that Her Royal Highness Aunt Margaret and that sparkling sports personality, Emlyn Hughes, have agreed to be at the top of the telecom tower, which is marvelous, because there won't be any cameras there. My father, the Duke of Edinburgh, has offered to help make sure the whole thing runs smoothly and efficiently. He's going abroad. One will wear jodhpurs and demonstrate how to calm down a wild, dumb creature by simply blowing up its nose. This treatment doesn't always work on Princess Michael of Kent. One will also be organizing a sponsored royal wave, which, as Mother always says, is what one's right arm is for. So, if you want to support the Princess-a-thon, then send your donation in an envelope and pop it into one of Mother's post boxes. Or, if you prefer, pop round to your local Cartier's, where you will be able to purchase one of these. And like all of these celebrities, you can wear it with pride. Thank you, and good night.
All right. When did you remove the revolving doors?
Come in.
Good morning.
Good morning. Please take a seat. Make yourself comfortable. What can I do for you?
I've come about the advertisement in the paper.
What paper?
This one. The Evening News.
Oh, yeah. What does it say?
It says, improve your memory 100%. Ring 662244.
That's my number.
Yes, it's your advertisement.
Oh, yes. I remember it now. Yes.
Well?
Well, what?
Well, could I enroll in the course?
Oh, certainly, certainly, yes. I'll just have to take down a few formalities. Could I have your name, please?
Yes, it's Arthur Brown.
Arthur Brown. And could I have your name, please?
Arthur Brown.
Arthur Brown. Well, Mr. Brown, what can I do for you?
I want to improve my memory.
Well, you've certainly come to the right place. I'll just have to take down a few particulars. Could I have your name, please?
It's Arthur Brown.
Arthur. Have you been here before?
No, you've just written my name down.
According to my notes, there's three of you.
Look, could you please just help me improve my memory?
Oh, I'm so sorry. When did you first start losing your memory?
I can't remember.
Do you remember anything at all?
Nothing except my name.
Which is?
Arthur Brown.
You know, what a coincidence. You're the fourth one we've had in this morning.
No, I think you've just written my name down four times.
What? Oh, yes, sir! Sir, what a scatterbrain. Still, what can I do for you, Mr.
Arthur Brown, I want to improve my memory.
Do you know, it's funny you should say that.
Why?
Well, I just read this advert in the paper today. It said, improve your memory 100%. Perhaps they could help you. Would you like to phone them?
Oh, yes. Can I use this phone?
Certainly. Go ahead.
Do you have the number?
Yes, yes, yes. It's 66 22 44. Affair International.
Hello, I wonder if I could make an appointment with you.
Oh, certainly, certainly, but I'm rather busy at the moment with a Mr...
Brown.
Brown. If you'd like to just come round in, say, a few moments, that'll be fine.
Oh, fine. Thank you very much.
Okay. Bye.
Well, thank you very much indeed. Sorry to cause a fuss.
No trouble at all.
Goodbye.
Well, it could have been of help. Bye-bye. Janet, can you get me the file on Mr... forget it. Come in.
Good morning.
Morning. Maybe if you please sit down, make yourself comfortable.
I want to improve my memory.
Yes, well, you've certainly come to the right place. Your name?
Good Lord, I swear I've been here before.
Could I have your name, please?
That's why I'm easy. I'm easy like Sunday morning.
One day, Derek was playing footy. But when he changed side, he was playing tennis. Derek was puzzled. In fact, it was a double-sided jigsaw puzzle from Weetos. There are four to collect, one free in every special pack of Weetos.
The big news is £10 off all women's raincoats at Goldberg.
Another great offer from Goldberg. We promise you'll like it.
Have a booking yet?
No.
I beg your pardon.
No, we haven't booked.
Oh, but you insult me. You dare to walk through the door of Le Poisson d'Amour without first reserving a table? We have booked, I tell you.
But we looked through the window and there were plenty of empty tables.
All booked.
What, all of them?
All of them. Booked by people with stars. People who do not start eating at a miserable quarter past 7.
Well, The reason we came so early was because we knew you were so popular.
Peasants!
Oh, please, couldn't you just squeeze us in? Well, we're dying to tell our friends we've eaten here.
Are you local people?
Oh, yes, yes, we just live round the corner.
Then where were you in the early days when the tables were empty and the owner's children went hungry? Oh, now, yes, we are popular. But always you wait for other people to discover us. You gastronomic pygmies!
Gastronomic pygmies?
Look, we're not looking for your respect. We just want a table, okay?
There might be a table later on.
Oh, good.
At 1 o'clock in the morning.
Must have something earlier.
You wish to book a table or not?
Yes, all right. Could we wait in the bar?
First, I shall need your telephone number.
Why?
In case you don't show up.
We're already here.
Do you have any idea how much money we have lost through people what don't show up? Telephone number.
731-3344.
Your address and don't gabble.
24 Western Gardens.
Do you have any identification?
Oh, here.
You have put on weight, haven't you, Fatso? Now I shall require a deposit. Shall we say your trousers?
What's going on?
Just a minute!
How dare you! Stop this man immediately!
Look, this is absolutely ridiculous.
You're next, sweetie. Get your togs off and put this on.
What? I've never been so excited.
Edward, you have forgotten the crudités.
Oh, pardon. You pair of pillets. You couple of sweaty peasants.
How dare you!
Thank you, Edward. I love it when you talk dirty.
We're just not putting up with this.
Then you don't get a table.
We don't care. We wouldn't eat here if you paid us. Come on, darling.
Absolutely. We're important people in this area, and we'll be telling all our friends about your disgusting behavior. I shan't rest until you're ruined.
I think they meant it, Pierre. That's the 12th couple tonight.
I know. Great, isn't it? That takes that pig of an owner to give me the sack.
You're satisfied? Blooming expensive, this parrot.
Yes, but I got him, didn't I?
I wonder who the mystery bidder was who put the price up so high. It's a lot to pay for a parrot, £300.
310!
And the British champion going for a new world record lift of £438. He's preparing for it. He's psyching himself up for the incredible lift of £438. And he's going for it. Fantastic, a new world record. Let's see if we can get a quick word with the champ. Champ, congratulations, a new world record. In your own words, how does it feel?
You put the kids' toys away after you. What a mess. Why don't you tidy up?
Why don't you tidy up yourself?
Don't talk back to me, you old gannet.
Don't old gannet me, you scruffy crazy. You didn't stay so late after work every night. You could help me more around the house.
Where's my tea?
Crisp and smoky in the oven.
No, not further, gannet. I'd sweat your bed cheese and biscuits, you would.
Go You'll kill her yourself then.
You've moved my uniform.
Uniform?
Yeah, uniform. You've got it all over the shoulder. Who are you?
You?
Sorry, I must have the wrong house. This ain't number 32, then?
Oh, no, I'm sorry, this is number 41.
Oh.
I'll tell you what, I'll get you a cup of tea while you're here anyway, all right?
No, it's all right, you know, I'll be off then.
All right.
What are you doing here?
I was just leaving.
Oh, yeah.
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 That you, Lord?
Yeah. That you?
Yeah.
Well, who's he?
Who?
The traffic warden.
Oh, we did the wrong house. He just came here by mistake.
Oh, yeah.
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 Don't start that again.
I was just making him a cup of tea, love.
Tea? Well, that's cosy.
Stop getting jealous, you.
I'll show you what jealous is, girl. Get in here. I want... Who are you?
This is number 69, then.
I'm sorry, this is number 41.
Yeah, I thought it was number 32.
I thought it was number 69.
Well, you might as well have a cup of tea while you're here, are you?
No, it's all right.
No, it's all right. You know, we'll be off then.
Yeah. Warm, love.
Is that you, love?
What are these two doing here?
They just got the wrong house and they're making them a cup of tea, all right?
Tea? Oh, that's cosy.
That's what I just said.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Did you get the Uber, love?
What? You asked me to get sugar.
Please, love.
Oh, thanks, love.
Who are you?
Sorry, I must be in the wrong house. This ain't number 14, then.
No, I'm sorry, love. This is number 41.
I thought it was number 32.
I thought it was number 69.
I thought it was 14. Still, they all look the same, these houses, on Crestwood Crescent, don't they?
Oh, yeah. No. This is Crestwell Crescent.
No.
I'm in the wrong house.
Looking everywhere, haven't found him yet. He's the big affair I cannot forget. Only man I ever think of with regret. Yeah.